Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I've done the one round on the field. Actually, just a moment, let me, I need to just check what it is again. Right, it's the left alt button. I always forget which one it is when I'm doing this, and I wanted to just bring up that one so I can see the outside. There we go. Press the left alt again, and I'll move into this corner here, gather up the last of this, and once around the field has filled the combine. Yeah, there we go. Right, it is remembering some of the controls sometimes. I'll just gather up that little bit down there, and then we will take a second round around this field before we finish. I've got something else that I want to do. Sorry, I'm just sort of trying to concentrate. I have something else that I want to do today as well as continue with this harvest, and that is go up to field 5 with the Deutz, and I'm going to use that one to start cultivating the field so that it's all ready. We'll do, once this combine is ready to, there we go, we're almost full. But yeah, once this combine has done another round, we can leave the hired help doing this, and then we can go and get the Deutz tractor, and we can take it up to field 5, and we can start harvesting up there. Right, I'm almost full. 98, 99, and then we'll rush over and we'll get the John Deere and we'll unload. That is almost it. A little bit more, there we go. Full quantity. Excellent. Right, and I'm just going to pop out of cab. We'll unload, we'll put the unloading auger out. There we go. That is quite a tank of grain. That is quite impressive. So anyway, let's hop out and we'll run over and get this John Deere. It's a little while. While we're running, the question that I asked you for today was, and I don't actually remember what the question was. I do have it written down. Yes. Do I do any forestry? Do you want me to take some time out from regular farming at some point while I'm playing this map and do some forestry? And you have all said, yes, you would like me to do that. So at some point, I will do some forestry. I'm not quite sure when it will be, but I will definitely do some forestry. Today's question, do you want me, and I haven't found anywhere particularly good to place them, but do you want me to get a couple of greenhouses? I mean, I'm not sure how many I'll get, maybe 5 or 6, say 3 of each or something like that, but I would like to get a few greenhouses, but it's your vote, it's your game. You tell me in the comments down below, do you want me to get a few greenhouses? And I'll just show, I don't have enough money, so it's going to let me do it. Could I do it with, I just wanted to show you. I realise it kind of looks a bit odd, but here we go. Just want to show you where I can place them. There's only one place. That's the sheep there. And this field here, this is the sugar beet. We got a massive, great big field here. But it's level. It is completely level. And we might be able to put a line, once we've harvested it, I could grass a chunk of it out along the top of the field. And then we could put greenhouses along. We've got, where is it? There's a gate there so that we could get straight through from the farm and we could bring the manure over, or we could run it down the road and come in the gate there. But this would be the ideal place to put 6, maybe even 10 greenhouses, and then we can start using the manure that we're building up in there, and we'd also be able to bring some water in. So that is my question for today. Do you want me to eventually buy some greenhouses when we can afford them? Head down to the comments section. Let me know your thoughts. Right, now we're just going to dash it. We've wasted plenty of time now rabbiting on about that. So let's dash over here. And I am just going to come out of cab to see how it lines up here and how much we can squeeze in. Right, well, that lines up quite nicely. So we will, actually I'll turn the tractor off. I don't want to just leave it running continuously. And I'm stuck. There we go. Let's come over here. I've deliberately left the door closed on that one this time. That's emptying out. Let's have a look into the grain bin. But it does seem to empty out fairly slow, I think, compared to the other one. But that's all right. We can cope with that. So we've got our camera on the outside edge of the header there. I will put the auger away. I just want to see, have we got an auger view? Yeah, there we go. That is brilliant. I've just got to put that out so we can see the auger view. That comes out. Oh, that is sensational. That is brilliant. Right, that's the inside of the tank, and that's the two for the header. So this is the one that we want. Let's start this bad boy up again. And we're away. Okay, I'm going to do another round of the field. Sort of, I'll do one more round of the field, and then that'll be plenty. And then we can start letting the hired help do some of this. And while we're doing that, while he's sort of doing the next tank full of grain, we can head up the road with the Deutz tractor and the little cultivator that we got and start on field 5. We'll do a couple rounds around the outside, and then once we've done that, I'm leaving a great big chunk of crop there. That is not the way to do this. I did mention this before, this is a slight problem with the canola, is that the texture, it is quite difficult to see where the ripe canola is. And the looking inside the cab as well, it makes it a little bit more difficult. If I come out like this, it's partly because I had the wrong button on. There we go. If I'm coming out like this, I can see just a little bit better. This combine is actually fairly laggy. This one does take a fair bit. I think it's because of the second screen there. If I just turn that off a second, turn that one off. Yeah, my frame rate has just suddenly jumped up. So that really, it does take quite a bit out of the system. And my system isn't, a small system. It does have a bit of grunt to it. So let's just stop there and back round the corner. Probably should have picked the header up to do that, but that's all right. Sometimes I did used to pick the header up, and sometimes I would just leave it on the ground. It would sort of depend on what we were doing. If you're doing canola, you can get away with not picking the header up at all. And I am going to have to bring that one back again. See, I am already chopping out a chunk. When you're in cab, it doesn't seem to have so much of an impact. It seems to be when you're out of cab. Right, I'm going to finish doing this round the outside of this field, and then we can think about getting our cultivator going as well. Right, that is the end of the first two rounds of this field. And I'll just switch him off a second so that we can go a little bit faster. This is what I don't like about the in-cab view when the header is up. You just cannot see anything. So let's open that one out. Over to our trailer. And the best way that I can see to do this field, because of the way the hired help works, I'm thinking that I will start on that lower edge, and that will probably take me to about halfway on the field, and then I'll have to go and work from the top end of the field. It's not ideal. Actually, I could just start from there. Work out from there. That actually might be better. That's what we'll do. We'll work from this side, and we'll just sort of work our way across the field. And we are staying out of cab because of the header blocking our view. I'm not actually using auto combine or follow me or any of the mods like that at the moment. I wasn't planning to for this map, but I might in future maps. Once I've run this series with just the regular way of doing it, I might start introducing new mods like that. And I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do it yet, but it is something that I am thinking about. I am conscious that a lot of people do like to see those mods being used. But I've just set the hired help going, and we'll see how he gets on with just working his way back across the field. I think, actually, he's going to be okay. If I hop out here and run away, there we go. Now, we'll watch him just come back. I mean, it's going to take a little bit, it does take a little while for him to get started, but I think overall this is going to be the best way to do it. He's got plenty of room to turn round. That's not going to be a problem. So I'm just going to come down here, and I will move the John Deere so that it's not going to get in the way of the harvester once he gets down this far. So let's start up, and we're at 57%, so we're not doing too bad. We'll easily take another full tank of grain, and I'm going to turn round with this one, and then I will park further up over here. We've got the road that runs down the side of this field. There we go. If I just come up, I think that's as far as I need to go, really. There we go. Right, I will stop there, and I think we can leave the cab open. There we go. And now climb out. There. Oh, he's in the mud. There he is. Look at that. That does actually... I do like the way that some of the mud textures do that. I think that is actually pretty cool. I like that. Right, anyway. I need to get over to the farm and get that Deutz hooked up to the cultivator and get up to the field with it. I'm just coming up to the field. The Lexion we can see there is at 28%. So we've got a little bit of time before we need to start worrying about it. And I was thinking actually of buying a pickup or something like that so that we can travel between the different parts of the farm when we need to. So I'm going to come out of cab so that we can see this. And I need to do at least two rounds around the field, I think. And before I start doing anything else, it's coming up quite nicely. The tractor seems to cope with it. I need to get over towards the edge a little bit more. Sure, I do that. There we go. Right, let's go in cab. Well, that comes up fairly well. It is going to take a little bit of time to get the first couple of rounds on the field. Actually, I think I'm going to need three or four rounds, to be honest. But I can do this, and then when the combine is getting close to full, I can phone up my wife and ask her to run me back up to the field so that I can drive the trailer up to the combine, because obviously we got hired help on the combine, but we don't have hired help on the tractor. So that would make a bit of a difference. This is coming on. Okay, I'm going to do some of this out of cab so that we can see what is going on. I do like to see it, and I especially like this bit. Oops. Okay, let's just pick that out. I don't like leaving bits of crop on the edge there, but I do quite like the, you know, the little scraps that are left over. I think it looks pretty cool. Actually seeing them get cultivated in, it's very satisfying for some reason. It is. I mean, I know what you mean. I know what you're saying. It's you know, simple pleasures, but it is very, very satisfying to see it all cultivated in like that. It's brilliant. This is looking grand. Okay, I'm gonna not bore you with too much of this, because quite frankly this is not the most exciting job in the world. I'm going to go on and do a round or two until we get close to needing to unload that combine. Okay, apparently I don't own this field. I'm assuming it's something to do with the trigger points on field 31 rather than field 29. I'm not really sure, so I'm going to drive down here, keep going, and we'll see what it's doing. It's coming up little patches saying that I don't own it. We were able to harvest it, so we didn't get it from that. I'm hoping that the next time round the field is not going to come up with that, but it does look like the border between this and field 31 is... Yeah, it doesn't like it at all. It's not letting me cultivate any of it. I don't know how far out that line is. Okay, I'm going to have to try driving into the field. Still don't own the field. Huh. Oh, there. Now, I am actually cultivating little bits of it here. So we got a bit of a stripe coming out, which actually that does mean that... Oh, there we go. Right, so the border for the field just there is out quite a way from the actual hedge of the field. So we'll have to just keep an eye on that when we come back around again, move further into the field. But it does look like the first field that we actually go and buy could very well be that field there, which is, that was field 31. That was the one that was causing the problem. So I think that might be the next one that we get. Now, we're up to 73% on our combine, and I've nearly completed once around the field, so I'm going to keep going until it gets to 90%, and then I will hitch a lift up to the field so that we can empty out that combine. Okay, he's heading up across the field there. His auger is out, lights flashing. He's still sat there, quietly, minding his own business. So let's go. What we'll do is we will get our load of corn from our load of canola from the combine, and once we've done that, we're going to take this back down to the sheep farm and tip it into the canola shed down there. That'll be the best way to do it. Now, can I do this in cab and actually unload it properly? If the combine is completely full and stops, that'll be easy. Anyone can do that, I hope, he says. So we'll wait and see. It is completely full, so I do have a chance of being able to do this correctly. And let's go underneath. There we go. Now, the only problem I got with this trailer is you can't quite see. Because of the... It's not the trailer, it's the person in here. It does kind of block the view somewhat. So let's just come out and see what we're doing. I'll move forward a little bit. And I can't remember what the complete capacity of this trailer is. Is it 39? I don't remember. Let's just take a quick look in the shop a second. So that we can see what the capacity is. Tippers, the Fliegl bull is 32,000. So we are actually at 28, almost 29,000. We are just about completely full. So we're going to drive straight out and we'll let the combine carry on. We're going to get down to the sheep farm and unload this back into the shed. All right. Come out onto the road, so there's no cars. It's the cars coming the opposite way that usually the trouble, because they don't stop for you and allow you to come out. They do make life difficult. But at least we've got through there, and I'm going to get in here before that car gets up to me. Just squeeze in quick before he can do anything about it. Now I've got to try and back into the shed. It is the middle shed, and I'm hoping that our trailer isn't too tall. That would be an absolute disaster. Well, not a complete disaster. We would just have to go and start selling direct to the village. Now, I cannot see a thing. Oops. It would help if I turned off my indicators. So I really am going to have to be out of cab to that. I think we'll be all right for tipping as well. I don't think it's going to hit the roof or anything like that. So come in round. There we go. Right into the middle. And tip. There we go. Well, everything seems okay. I can't pull forwards once it's up because it will collide with the shed. I just have to hope that the heap doesn't push the trailer up too high. At the moment, it seems okay. I am tempted to take a load of this straight to the shop. Although, I'm thinking that if we can get away with it, it would be better if we could wait for a great demand or something like that, because we would obviously we'd get a lot more money if we could sell this on a great demand. I don't recall seeing any great demands yet. That's the only issue. So are we going to get great demands on this map? I guess we'll find out in the next day or two. Now I'm going to take this back up to that field. We'll see if we can just run alongside the combine and unload that little bit, and then we can go back over to our cultivating. It's just come to the end of the row there, which means we'll have to sit here and wait for him to go all the way back up across the field before that we can run alongside him and unload him. And I'm thinking it'd actually be better if I just go off and do a little bit more cultivating before we finish. So I'll switch that one off and get out of the tractor. There we go. We'll let that one go up through. And I'm going to go off to the cultivator and do a little bit more with that. I do actually only have half a tank of fuel, which is something that I kind of neglected to notice when I first came out here. I probably should have filled up, but fortunately, that little rough patch down over there in the corner of the field over there, I think there is a fuel tank in there. I'm hoping there is, because that means I've only got to just nip out of the gateway and down there to fill up, rather than going all the way back to the farm, which is going to take quite a while. Probably I'm going to need to go twice more around this field in order to have enough space so that the hired help can turn on the headland and everything. And then once that's done, this one can just carry on. So I am actually coming to the end of the episode now. I'm going to continue just doing this, and I'll also continue with that field of canola between now and next episode. I will get as much of it done as I can. I would like to be in a position where I am... Yeah, we are. See, I'm now... Oh, no. It's going back to I don't own this field. I'll just drive out until I get to a patch where it will actually let me cultivate. I'm going to have to leave a big stripe down here. We're going to have to buy this field as soon as possible. I don't like leaving this much of the field because the game thinks that I don't own it. Yeah, I don't like this. Right, now I can sort of bring it back in a little bit. But this, yeah, it's stopping me again. But it's going to leave little patches, I think. And now we should be okay. So, yes, the question for today was... Do you want me to buy some greenhouses? Will you want me to invest in some greenhouses at some point before I finish playing this map? So that we can fill them up and, you know, maybe earn a little bit of money with them, that sort of thing. If you do, head down below, let me know in the comment section. If you don't, head down below, let me know in the comment section as well. It's your vote, it's your game. I will continue on and get this ready for the hired help to just sort of finish this field on his own. And I will also continue with the canola harvest and probably get most of that finished before next episode so that we can move straight into the field of barley that is directly opposite the sheep farm. Now, I'd like to get a good chunk of that done tomorrow as well. We want to get as much combining done as we possibly can because obviously we're limited to time because of the hire time. And I didn't want to extend it because it is quite expensive. But if you've enjoyed this episode... then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.